made a huge mistake. We broke the rules of the universe, you might say. We created a certain kind of field called an external Merkaba, which is a counter-rotating field of light based on nature. And we lost control of it, which is now called the Bermuda Triangle, and which is where this was located. And that caused us to fall from a very high level of consciousness down to where we are now. And in so doing, we began to breathe in a different pattern, which produces the way that we interpret the one reality now, which we call polarity consciousness. We see everything as good or bad, or black and white, or up and down. And the results of everything that are coming, that are happening within this reality now for the last 13,000 years are a result of that one happening that happened during the end times of Atlantis. And Egypt is part of Atlantis, you might say. The primary person in Atlantis was a man named Chicotet Arlitz Bomalites, who was the same person who began the procedure in Atlantis, who was called Thoth. He was the scribe of Thoth of Egypt and wrote everything down. And all of Egypt then was, their function was to begin to remember who we were from before during the time of Atlantis. And they began the procedure of learning what resurrection was about. And it was everything that was going on in Egypt was really trying to remember how to do something that we had learned a long time ago and then forgot.
You say that there are new advancements in consciousness going on. What's going on today?
Well, today, in this moment right now, there are extraordinary things going on. This is actually the subject of the talk that I'm going to be giving tomorrow. There are many phenomena that are occurring on the earth right now that are outside of normal consciousness completely. And we as a human race are aware of some of these things, but they have been distorted by the governments in such a way that we don't know whether to believe them or not, or what they really mean. And the first one of this is something that's been going on for 52 years, which has to do with the UFOs that have been appearing all over the world and are still appearing. And they began on a single day in Europe in 1946. And in June and July of 1947 in the United States. And they've been appearing ever since then, that time. And they still are. And then there's another phenomenon, which is the cross circles of the world, which has been going on for 27 years. And our governments have never been able to figure out who they are or what's doing it. When you really understand the science behind it and look into videos like Colin Andrews' video, which is called Undeniable Evidence, you'll see that the cross circles are grown in place and not pushed, and that there is another phenomenon happening here that people need to understand. And we are being kept from what that really is all about also. But those have been going on for a long time, and we just sort of see them in the background, they don't go away. And then a new one has come forth just a few years ago, which is what's going on with the first five books of the Bible, of the Torah. And the past and the present and the future being depicted in the Bible itself in a computer code. This book, Michael Dresden, is now on the New York bestseller list, and yet very few people still really know what this is about. This is an extraordinary thing that's occurring. But now there's even more extraordinary things than that.
Well, let's hear about them just after this. I haven't bought the whole idea of the Bible code. I think, you know, you can find anything you want if you allow yourself to take every other letter and every millionth letter and all of that. That's not convincing to me. But anyway, your call to welcome after Drunvalo explains what he thinks is going on today, Eddie. And before we get to callers, though, a lot of questions. So what's going on for today, in your opinion?
Well, those three things are only an indication of what's going on. There are other factors that are beginning to emerge in the world that the rest of the world is hardly aware of that are extraordinary. What's going on in China with the psychics that are developing over there
What's going on in China?
Well, there's a psychic expansion of consciousness that's never been seen before in history.
How is it evidence? What are the clues?
The government of China is evidencing it. And they are, they first found a child, a Tengyu, young child, who was able to read with his ears, who could read books by just holding them up to his ears or anything up to his ears.
And then reciting what's in them?
Yeah, read perfectly. They test them over and over and over. He's perfect.
So where do we get the stories about this?
Well, there's a book called, actually the first writing that came to the United States was an Omni magazine in January 1985. Though it's been written in Nature magazine and many scientific journals around the world and especially all over China, the phenomenon is becoming huge.
You mean more people
are claiming they can walk through walls, that they can make things appear out of nothing, that they're able to do things that seemingly are like Superman. And yet, it's not just one or two people, it's thousands and thousands of them, and most of them are children.
Why China?
Well, that's a good question. And we're still trying to understand why China, because it's primarily happening there, but it's not just China. I was just in the jungles of Mexico. There's a young girl there named Ingrid who is able to put her foot onto a book and read everything in it with blindfolds all over her eyes, and when she did it right for us, she could just...
Oh, you saw her do that?
Yes. She could pick a photograph and without being able to see it, tell you everything on it, exactly who it is, what the names of people are when they're born, and anything you want to know about it.
How old was she?
She's 18 years old.
Wow.
And there are many people appearing all over the world right now. This phenomena is not going to go away. It's growing faster and faster and faster.
What do you call this phenomenon?
Right now, I don't know. There's a book by Paul Dong called The Super Psychics of China, which depicts all of this. It just came out recently. It's beautiful.
Uh-huh.
And it tells you everything and all the scientific data that China is finding out about this and what's happening about it, that it really is real.
Yeah.
And then you have another book by Lee Carroll that's came out called The Indigo Children, which is another DNA change in humanity, which is happening primarily in the United States.
A DNA change, describe that one.
Well, that's a DNA change also in you have three kinds of children changing right now. One is psychic, which is a right brain, and you have the left brain, which is called the indigo children, and you have another one that are called the children of AIDS. And that would be documented by Greg Braden in a book called Walking Between the Worlds. But and all of them have DNA changes that are completely unique. But the indigo children are, again, a brand new kind of child that no one's ever seen before. They only began to see these since 1988. They have very high IQs. They are a response to our technological world. They are different than normal children.
How so? How are they different besides the non-high IQ?
The way that they respond, the way they think, the way they see the world, they're claiming that they even have a different kind of liver than other children.
A different kind of liver?
Yes.
Hmm.
And they are simply different. And this book is called The Indigo Children. It's by Lee Carroll. And this just came out. It's brand new. It's the research, and it's all written primarily by doctors and medical people and psychologists,
yeah.
Not just by Lee Carroll. This is an effect that is being observed mostly in the Western world where we are technical. They don't find any of these kind of children in China, for example, or in South Africa. And then you have the children of AIDS, which is an amazing situation that's going on.
The children of what?
The children of AIDS.
Okay.
They're children that were born with AIDS, and they have been documented to be born with AIDS. But for some reason, when they get to be about 4 or 5 years old, the AIDS vanishes. No trace. It isn't that it's hidden in their body. It is gone forever. And when they have tested them on their DNA level, they have a different DNA. It's not human. They don't have human DNA. They have something else.
You mean it's that much of a change?
They have four new codons.
They
have four brand new codons. We have 20. They have 24. And they're very specific codons that are being turned on. And these children have our immune systems that are so strong that they are immune to just about, and probably everything. And there are not just a few of these kids. According to the Aaron Diamond Research Center, which researches AIDS, it's 1% of the world, which translates into 60 million children.
Well, there aren't that many children born with AIDS, though.
Well, at this point, something else is beginning to happen, it appears, because these are not just children anymore. Initially, it was just children, but now they're finding adults and all kinds of people with it. It seems to have moved across into different spectrums of the population, including people that never had AIDS. It's just like the original test that happened with the monkeys, the hunter's monkey that was done many years ago in Japan, where you had one monkey who began to wash the sweet potatoes in the ocean.
Mm-hmm.
And then that monkey taught its friends. And first of all, it was all originally young monkeys who did this. And then the mother began to do it, and then the mothers began to do this. And finally, in a single day, the entire island began to do it. And then other islands that were not even connected to this place, all the monkeys on there did it. All the even on the mainland China, on the same day, began to wash their potatoes and get the sand off of them. And this phenomena now is probably beginning to be seen in humanity in the form of changing the DNA. They're mutating.
I've also called it the popcorn effect, where you have one kernel popping and then more and more and more, and suddenly the whole batch is transformed.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
What do you make of this?
I think that we are responding to this. If you look at a book called Eat Right for Your Fight.
Oh, Peter DiBalmo.
Okay. Forget about whether or not he's right on what foods you eat and things like that. The theory around it is that for millions of years, or however long we've been on this planet, there was only one blood type, and that's type O, and we were all meat eaters. And then, in a very short period of time, when we began to become farmers, and we stayed in one place, by having a new climate, by having a new diet, etc., whatever the trigger was, we suddenly changed our DNA, and we created a new blood type, which is type A. And
so we changed in response to changes in our environment.
Yes, especially food. And now we have a brand new kind of situation here in the world, rapidly changing knowledge, never seen before. Many, many things that are happening now, the population level, things that have never, ever been seen. New kinds of foods, again, that we're eating because the foods are being shuffled from all over the world. And you're seeing the DNA response to it just like we did 15,000 years ago.
What do you think this is going to lead us?
I don't know, but I think it's great.
Have you done some research as to what are the special conditions under which people seem to add more codons or change their DNA?
Yes.
What do they have in common?
Well, I sat with Greg Braden and talked to him about this, and he believes it has to do with a certain emotional response that they're noticing from some of the universities, that a very specific response that when seen at timely signature on the computer is almost identical to the DNA molecule itself. And they believe that that's how they're accessing the DNA, by becoming a response similar to the DNA. And it appears from Greg's belief that the closest word that would say what that emotional response is compassion. However, I believe that there is something else that is different, that is also, and I'm just becoming aware of this in the last couple months or so, that it has to do with the psychic energy involved in all of this. And this is what they're finding in China scientifically.
Let's go to the telephones, Drunvalo, and talk first to, oh gosh, Laura in Fontana. Would that be California? Where is that?
Laure Lee?
Yes, hi there. Yes.
Hi, I'm listening to you out of Albuquerque in Fontana.
Oh, okay.
It's close to the casino.
Great. Well, welcome, Laura.
Thank you, Laure Lee. Drunvalo?
Yes.
It's an honor and a privilege to speak with you. I have a question for you.
Okay.
As everyone knows, we're approaching a major shift in humanity's consciousness. Do you foresee any major Earth changes on the North American continent prior to the year 2012?
Well, I do, but I wouldn't be too concerned about it. Because there's something else happening in consciousness that I believe is going to take place in such a way that we're going to